is the perfect RIA, in case you didn't know. Bringing you all the strategies to help your business grow. Are you happy? Are you satisfied? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Sit back and listen in while you feel the beat, yeah. Another myth bites the dust.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Follow Up Friday. I'm your host, Matthew Jarvis. Now, if you ever wonder where Micah is on Follow Up Friday, he's not here because I get the responsibility of doing Follow Up Friday. There's an interesting lesson to be drawn from this, which is there are times where you need your entire team. There's times where Micah and I need to collaborate together. There are also times where your team needs to divide and conquer. As this relates to your team, you need to look and say, where do I need to work with my team on items? Where do I need to let my team simply do their own thing? For example, I don't need Micah to help me with follow-up Fridays. I would love it. It would be great fun. These would be more enjoyable for me as I have a great time with Micah. But our productivity is increased when we can do things separately. So a side action item not related to Monday's episode is watch for opportunities to let your team do their thing. They don't need you to hold their hand the entire time. All right, back to the subject at hand. On Monday's episode, Micah and I talked about the vast amount of information he and I consume, the dozens of books that we read, the conferences we attend, the white papers we read, the content that we produce for the Perfect RIA, for retirement tax services, and pointed out that the most successful people in any industry, but especially ours, consume vast amounts of information. And the takeaway from that is if you want to significantly increase your success in any area, significantly increase the amount of time that you are devoting towards learning, towards what we call personal development. Now, this can easily be used as an avoidance behavior. So doing personal development in lieu of your prospects calls does not count. However, doing personal development in lieu of checking email or of watching, perusing the internet or of watching television or any of those horrible things does count. Three action items. Action item number one, measure and then double your consumption of valuable data, right? Mike and I recited all the things. I'm typically reading three or four books at once at any given time. Micah is consuming vast amounts of information. If you want to double your success, action item number one, double your consumption. Action item number two, you must have personal development time scheduled every week and not over the top of your prospecting time. This means you need to say, hey, these are the hours I've set aside for personal development. Here is, five-star tip, here is the list of things I'm going to study. Now, I would have far more on that list than you can possibly get to during your block and simply add to that list. That way, throughout the week, when you're not in personal development time and you see an interesting article or a webinar or a podcast, you can simply add that to the list and saying, hey, when I get to personal development time, here is what I'm going to study. Here is what I'm going to learn. Third and final action item for today, take a speed reading class. Speed reading class. We've recommended for years that you take a comedy class because it will dramatically improve your public speaking. Taking a speed reading class, even an online one, will dramatically improve the amount of information that you are able to digest. So, as always, it's not what you know that counts, but what you take action on. And until next time, happy planning.
Hold on before we go. Something that you need to know. This isn't tax, legal, or investment advice. That isn't our intent. Information designed to change lives. Financial planning can make you thrive. Start today, don't think twice. Be a better husband, father, mother, and wife.